Now let's take a look at what happens when we make a partial bill payment, meaning we only pay a part of an unpaid bill. The reports that we looked at before will change in the same way as they did when we made an exact payment. The two accounts in the trial balance change the same way. The balance goes down on the vendor balance detail, but the interesting part happens on the open invoice. For example, if April 24, we paid $600 to UPS for bill number 7373, and of course the check number is the next consecutive number, it means we're only paying a part of bill number 7373. Now, if you look at the unpaid bill report in the section of UPS, the amount that we owe for bill number 7373 is $1,600. After we pay $600 towards this bill will still be on the unpaid bill report, but if we pay it down by $600, it will not show at the current amount. If we pay it down by $600, then after we save that bill payment, this bill, number 7373, will still be on this report, but it will show $1,000 even. From the main menu, click Vendor, Pay Bills. And of course, we set it up in the way that we saw before. Sort by vendor and filter by just UPS. Now we can see only the unpaid bills that we have with UPS. Make sure the date is the appropriate date for writing the check. Make sure that you will put the check number, because this is a handwritten check, number 209. Now, the difference between paying a full bill and a partial bill is when you click the check mark here, QuickBooks assumes you're paying the whole bill. If you are only paying a part of the bill, you have to double click on the amount, highlight the amount in the field, and overtype it with only the amount that you're paying. To save the field, push the tab key. So now you have a partial payment of $600 to a bill that has $1,600 due. Again, if you click the check mark, you're paying the whole thing. Highlight only the money amount on the right, type in the amount, and push tab. When we click pay selected bill, you have to type in the check number in the next window, 209, because we are not printing this check. Click OK. Click Done to confirm. Now when we look at the bill down here at UPS, we can see this has decreased to $1,000 even, but it is still on the unpaid bill report. Every bill has a history, the same way that every invoice for customers has a history. The history explains the balance and shows you what the balance was on different dates. When we take a look at the unpaid bill report, we can see that this is the bill that we just had a partial payment applied to. When we double click, we can see the bill in front of us. On the Reports tab, in the ribbon under the Reports tab, we have a choice for transaction history. When we click, we see that this bill was originally $1,600, but then on April 24th, we wrote check 209 in the amount of $600 that brought this bill's balance down to $1,000. We could even select this payment and go to it, but remember, the pay bills window looks different after you reopen it, and this is what it would look like.